From Vince Scully Avenue, welcome to Dodger Stadium. The show presents the National League Division Series. It's the New York Mets taking on the Los Angeles Dodgers. With Chris Singleton, I'm John Ciampi. With Game 6 in front of us, it's an elimination game on one side, but this series feels like it could go either way.
You know, Boog, some of the greatest games in baseball history have been a Game 6, so I'm fired up for this one. And clearly, being at home with a 3-2 lead in the series is a huge advantage, but it's far from a guarantee. They've still got to go out there, handle their business, and not let this get to a Game 7.
And the odds are obviously against any team trying to win a Game 6 and Game 7 on the road. But it does happen. They don't consider this series over by any means. First pitch coming your way next. Just a little bit away from first pitch. And today's starter, Clayton Kershaw. And Singy, he's one of the most dominant arms in all of baseball.
Well, last time out, picked up the win, didn't allow a run, pitched extremely well. He doesn't have to be perfect, but if he can give another performance like last time out, his team will be happy.
Okay, all set to go. And stepping in for New York, Brandon Nimmo. Kershaw fires. And that one wrapped foul. Next offering misses, and the count is 2-2. That one blasted deep to right. Way back there. And that ball is gone. The first batter of the game leaves the yard. His second home run of the series, and that gives him a lead. It's 1-0.
Well, you got to love a game that brings some action from the jump. And at the plate, he was looking for a pitch to absolutely drive. And, you know, leadoff hitters aren't up there anymore just working the count, trying to get on. They're looking to make some noise and do some damage.
Starling Marte up to hit. 2-2. The punch out there and one out now.
Committed to that breaking ball just a little too much and couldn't pull the bat back in time. You know, once you get it going, it can be so tough to stop the momentum of that barrel. Good pitch, had him fooled.
And now it's even up.
Part of the order coming through now, and with one home run already in this inning, they're definitely looking to do some more damage.
And now the lefty. Swing and a miss, struck him out. Back-to-back strikeouts.
He came out of his mechanics there. Typically likes to shoot the ball the other way, but that time, a little anxious.
And now it's the polar bear, Pete Alonso. Big-time power.
I think it's huge that they were able to score right away. You're playing on the road. Stakes are high. Energy in the ballpark. And you help to quiet that down a little bit.
The 1-2. That one drifts inside. Pitch misses there, and it's 3-2. Eighth pitch of the at bat coming up. And he walked him.
Didn't miss by much right there. Just couldn't get the call off the inside corner.
Here's Mark Canna. next offering clips the zone count even at two. On the ground, right side. And he can't come up with it. But they get the out at first, and that'll do it for the inning. Another look here at the solo shot leading off the ball game. It's now a 1-0 ball game. We go to the bottom of the first. And on the mound in this one, Chris Bassitt.
Well, he's got great stuff, but what makes his stuff even better is his delivery. Hides the ball for a very long time, high leg kick, and by the time the hitter sees it, it's right on top of him.
Back here in L.A., Mookie Betts will get us started. Ripped to third and caught.
Batting second.
Time to check out the Dodgers lineup. All right, Singy, how about all the talent in this lineup?
They're deep, first and foremost, but the way that they can manipulate their personnel for matchups and everything else, it's very intelligent the way that they use their team. And I think it creates a little bit of uncertainty for opposing teams, especially in a big game, big series.
Here's Trey Turner. That's out to center field. Nimmo moving in on this one. Makes a nice grab at a full sprint. Two down.
Batting third. The third baseman, Justin Turner.
Here's Justin Turner. The 1-1. And there's a foul ball. The 1-2. Rolled softly, but that goes foul. The wide to kick the pitch. Upstairs.
I got to count 2-2.
The wide of the pitch. And now the count filled up 3-2. In the air, out towards left center. Nimmo makes the catch, and that'll do it. Nothing doing for the Dodgers here. They're down 1-0. Second inning set to go. And stepping in for New York, Eduardo Escobar. Swing and a miss as he was out front.
He needs a quick 1-2-3 this time around. Last inning, threw a lot of pitches.
Line drive, caught. Now it's J.D. Davis. One down, base is empty. Way inside, gets out of the way. base hit. One gone, runner at first. Jeff McNeil stands in. Good contact guy, good defender. And it is 2-1. Kershaw the 2-1. That's off the mark. 3-1 now. Eric Summersgill with home plate duty in this one. Kind of known for being generous with the corners, Chris.
You know, I think that used to be a lot bigger deal in past eras where pitchers were working more in and out with their pitches. But, yeah, we'll see if those corners come into play in this one. Hey, no pitcher's going to argue at all.
And the 3-1. And a foul ball. Pitch, swing and a miss, and he's down on strikes, two away.
Came inside with that two-strike fastball nicely and just bunched him up on the inside part of the plate. Couldn't get around on it and catch it out front. Many times if you do, it's a foul ball. And you know, a lot of pitchers, they really don't like working inside with two strikes because they do not want to hit that batter. And when they've got him up against the ropes, got to figure out a way to put him away. Did a nice job right there.
Here is James McCann. Next pitch has popped up. Turner makes the catch, and that'll do it. Mets lead one, but they lead it 1-0. Back here at Dodger Stadium, here comes Freddie Freeman up to hit. One now. Slapped foul. Two down. And that one lifted in the air center field. Makes the catch for the out.
Batting fifth. The catcher.
The batter now will be Will Smith. This guy has turned into a beast. And a 1-1. Swung on, belted. That's back there. And it's gone. He'll touch them all. His second homer of this series. It's tied at 1.
There was a cutter away. Kind of works like a slider. You've got to stay on it, let it travel a little bit, and then get your arms extended. Really good piece of hitting right there.
Here comes Max Muncy. The wind of the pitch. Tapped at the plate, but it's a foul ball. Tied up here in the early going. Three, two now. Muncy hits one in the air. Nimmo has a beat on it. He makes the catch, and there's two down.
Batting seven, the left fielder, Chris Taylor.
Two outs, base is empty. Chris Taylor digs in now.
He's got pop, which is a little sneaky because he's so comfortable with taking his base hits to the opposite field, but he can jump you if you make a mistake.
So now one and two.
This guy's got such a good sinker. As a hitter, you've got to look up in the zone. If you look down, you're going to be chasing stuff in the dirt.
Next pitch just misses. Two and two. Kicks and fires. That one in the dirt, and it's a full count. Kicks and deals. And down on strikes. And that ends the inning. Dodgers tie it up with a solo homer. All even now at 1-1. Back here at the ballpark, new inning getting started. Stepping in, Brandon Nimmo. 1-1 now.
It's good speed at the top of the order here. You want to get it on, see if you can get a stolen base, maybe get around the bases and pick up a run.
That one misses. 2-2. The pitch. Got him. Now one away.
Boog, he was shopping at the buckle right there, the way that slider made him look. That was just nasty.
Here's Starling Marte. Went down on strikes his first time through. That one fouled off. The 1-2. Popped up. Freeman pulls it down. That's out number two.
Boy, that was a hanging breaking ball right there. I think he tried to do a little bit too much. Sometimes those eyes can get really big. I think his swing broke down as well, and that's what caused him to pop it up.
Now up to hit, Francisco Lindor. A switch hitter batting right. Next offering is fouled back. Hard hit to third. Zips it across. Lindor retired. And it's a 1-2-3 inning. Down in order go the Mets. Score remains deadlocked at one. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And now it's Gavin Lux. The pitch. Marte moving to his left. One, two now. Bounce back to the mound. And that squirts through. And the leadoff man aboard.
Really nice job staying up the middle with his approach. He didn't try to do too much with the pitch, just shot it through the infield. And now they've got some speed on first, so we'll see if they try to get him into motion.
Bellinger up to hit. The next offering misses. 2-1. Runner at first with no outs here. Next offering is down low. Chris, with that distraction and the speedy guy at first, he's in a favorable hitter's count.
Well, if nothing else, I mean, this is a great spot for a hitter to be in.
And ball four, two aboard.
Pretty easy walk right there. Last pitch wasn't even much to think about.
So the lineup flips over. Here's Mookie to hit.
If you don't get ahead in the count, you can forget about having any success against it.
You know, Boog, if you're that base runner at second base, you want to be quiet out there. Not bouncing around, not distracting your teammate, the hitter. Make sure that he can clearly focus on that pitcher and that release point.
In the air, out towards right center. Marte on the move to the alley. Makes the grab. Runner tagging for third. And he moves up 90 feet. Runners at the corners now. One away.
Batter number six. Shortstop.
Trey Turner with a chance now.
He's been such a good hitter with runners in scoring position. Some guys just take it to another level. For him right now at the plate, it's like everyone else is in slow motion and he's in full speed.
Swing and a ball lifted in the air, shallow left field. Lindor makes the play, and there are two down.
Yeah, that was a wasted RBI opportunity, but competitor like him, he is looking forward to making up for it in his next at bat.
Justin Turner now. Lux, the runner at third. Bellinger on at first with two down. And here it comes. Base hit. In comes the runner from third. It's 2-1. Throw in holds that trail runner at third base. They're at the corners with two away.
Mission accomplished there as he picks up the RBI to give him the lead. That pretty much split the zone down the middle, and those are the ones where you've got to make them pay.
Two gone with runners at the corners. And next for L.A., Freddie Freeman. The 1-1. A little out front there as he swings through it. Here's a 1-2. That's inside. On the ground right side. Dives and he can't hang on. To first and he beats it. Everyone's safe.
That's back-to-back singles for him. Pretty much did the opposite of what you want to do with the pitch on the outside part of the plate like that. Just rolled over, but good hustle down the line and got the infield knock.
So first and second with two outs. And up to the plate is Will Smith. He's already homered in this one. The next pitch misses, and it's 2-2. Two outs. 3-2 now. Two outs. Couple of base runners at first and second. Fouled off again. And it remains 3-2. Next offering is fouled back. Stays alive. Up the middle. What a stop. The throw. On the money, nice play. We're through three here in game number six. It's the Dodgers 3 and the Mets 1. As we go to the top of the fourth, here's Pete Alonso.
Well, after putting up a nice inning on offense, got some runs across, this is where you look for the starter to go out there, have a shutdown inning. Don't give that other team any hope. You just hope that he can get through this inning, get the bats back up there while they're hot.
He's got it, and there's one away. Mark Canna, the next to hit. Pretty good job on the mound in this one, Siggy. It feels like we've seen a lot of off-balance swings.
Yep, just one free pass, and obviously he's not a big strikeout guy, but he gets soft contact and he gets outs.
Now all even up. Foul ball.
Well, the hitter's got his timing down for the breaking ball. If you're a pitcher, if you can get that fastball in on the hands, it's going to be very difficult for that hitter to get the barrel to it.
That misses the zone. 3-2 now. Next offering popped in the air, right field. Betts makes the grab, and there are two outs. Two outs, base is empty. Eduardo Escobar, El Caballo up to hit. 0-for-1 so far. The big lefty turns, kicks, deals. Swing and a tapper that rolls foul. Next one misses, and that's ball two. And the pitch. And a foul ball. He stays alive. The wind and the pitch.
Count is 3-2.
To the right side. And Freeman, the gold glover, makes the play. The flip to the pitcher covering. Escobar out of the play. And that is that. On now to the bottom of the fourth. It's the Dodgers 3 and the Mets 1. Bottom of the fourth, and now it's Max Muncy. And 1-2.
This guy's sink has so much drop in it, it's almost like a split finger fastball. Instead of just weak contact and balls on the ground, he gets swings and misses.
Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him. Chris Taylor now. He's 0-for-1. The pitch. Rolled over to third. And it gets by him.
Man, he just absolutely turned on that one. Ripped it down the line. Nice job of staying in his mechanics.
And stepping in is the speedy Gavin Lux. Here's a 1-2. And it goes just foul. Taylor, the base runner at first with one out. Next pitch is downstairs.
This is one of those situations the infielders have to pre-plan and understand that the ball's going to be hit extremely hard right at them if they're going to have a chance to go for a double play.
Swings and misses, two out.
Well, I'm not sure what he was waiting on right there. He got the changeup and still late on it. You rarely see that. It almost makes you think that he was trying to set the pitcher up. I mean, if you can't catch up to the off-speed stuff, there's no way you're going to touch a fastball.
Here's Cody Bellinger. Next pitch misses, and a count 2-1. Right-hander kicks, deals, fouls one off, 2-2. And a pitch. There's a line drive to left field. Canna makes the catch, and that'll do it. So the Dodgers leave one, and the score stays 3-1. Back here at Chavez Ravine. Top five, John Ciampi with Chris Singleton. And leading it off, J.D. Davis. Here comes a pitch. Hey. Top of the zone, and it's called a strike. And a pitch. Stays alive. Next offering is fouled back. And a pitch. Next offering is outside. The wind of the pitch. That one the other way. Freeman takes it himself, and the leadoff hitter retired in the fifth. And now here's Jeff McNeil. Next offering is in for a strike. Swing and a ball popped up. Lux pulls that one down, and there's two down.
The catcher, number 33, James McCann.
Two outs, base is empty. James McCann in now. On the ground, out to short. And that's the third out. Last half of the fifth coming up. It's the Dodgers 3 and the Mets 1. And welcome back. We head to the bottom of the fifth. Now it's Mookie Betts. And that one hammered. That's back there. And in one hops the wall. And that's a leadoff double.
Well, here we are, third time through the order, and this is where we see the OPS jump up. Manager might have to go to the bullpen a little bit sooner than he anticipated.
Trey Turner at the plate. Here's a 1-1. And that one sliced foul. Betts leads off second with nobody out. That's ripped. Base hit. Flying around third is Betts. He'll score, and they're up by three. Pulls into second. That's an RBI double.
Well, he wasn't afraid to hit with two strikes. I think he choked up a little bit, maybe spread out, but he got the job done right there.
So a lefty out of the pen, David Peterson. He'll try to strand the runner at second.
Well, at this point of the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and he needs a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
So man aboard, and at the plate for the Dodgers, Justin Turner, 1-for-2. Hammer, base hit. Flying around third is Turner. He scores, and they lead by four. And in at second with an RBI double.
Nice double right there. Loud contact coming off the bat. Didn't get enough air under to drive it out of here, but you'll take that swing and that result every time.
Freddie Freeman up to the dish. Runner leads away at second. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. And he deals. And the 1-2 misses to even the count. Action in the Mets bullpen. Tylor Megill appears to be getting loose. Williams warming up as well. Got him looking. One away. Will Smith getting ready to hit. He's already homered here in this one. At the belt and fires. Swing and a line drive caught.
Now that the designated hitter, Max Muncy.
Here's Max Muncy, that funky Muncy. The pitch. And now 2-1. Runner at second, two down. Left-hand batter waits. That one misses, and it's 3-2. Man at second. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. The pitch. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
His ability to draw walks has been something that's been part of his career since day one.
So two down, Chris Taylor steps to the plate for the Dodgers. Kicks and fires. Chopped to the left side. To first, and he beats it. Everyone's safe.
Did a nice job getting there. Good throw, but very difficult to get anybody on that one as far as you had to go and throw, you know?
Yeah, no question.
So up next, Gavin Lux. kicks and deals. And a count one and two. Turner on third. Muncy on second. Taylor at first. Two out of the inning. Swing and a miss, and that is that. We're through five. It's the Dodgers five and the Mets one. Top of the sixth inning. Here's the Mets leadoff man, Brandon Nimmo. The Mets in striking distance, but have some work to do.
Boog, it starts with the leadoff man. I need a good at bat out of him right here.
And now the lefty puts it in the air out towards left center. Bellinger gliding back, makes the grab on the run, and there's one down.
Every day during batting practice, these outfielders get about 10 minutes of balls in the gaps. They practice this, and when the game comes, they make the play perfectly.
That one in for a strike, two and two.
He's pitching well, but not throwing a ton of first pitch strikes. Usually doesn't work out for success, but you can never predict baseball.
Swing, and this one's bounced on the ground. Throw on to Freeman. Two quick outs to open the top of the sixth. Two outs, bases empty. Francisco Lindor up now for the Mets. Here's a 1-1. This one popped up. Lux gets under it. He makes the grab. And that is the third out of the inning. 9-1 and 2 scheduled to hit in the home half of the sixth. It's the Dodgers 5 and the Mets 1. Back here in L.A., well, we go bottom six. And at the plate for the Dodgers, Cody Bellinger. Here's a 1-1. And a foul ball. The pitch. And now the count is even. Stirring in the bullpen for the Mets. Seth Lugo preparing to come on if needed. Smith getting loose as well. And now it's 3-2. The wind to kick the pitch. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout. Leadoff man retired in the sixth.
Oh, that slider down and away. It's just kind of a slow death. With two strikes, you're looking to protect. And halfway to the plate, you know you've committed. And you know you're going to have no chance of touching it. Tell you what, sometimes you just have to tip your cap.
Mookie Betts steps to the plate for the Dodgers. 1-for-3. Out to short. Lindor on to first. Two up, two down.
The batter number six. Shortstop. Turner.
Here's Turner now. The 1-1. Good eye right there.
He's done a great job getting the first two outs. Want to get this number two hitter, get back in the dugout, and face 3-4-5 next inning.
The pitch. Swing and a line drive and a base hit up the middle.
Everything was on time and fluid in that swing. Got a pitch he could get the barrel on and lined it into center for the knock. Those always feel good.
Two outs, runner at first. Turner climbs in on that right side. Peterson picks over, and he's back standing. Next pitch is in the dirt. 2-1.
Good speed on the base paths. He handles the bat very well. I wouldn't be surprised if the skipper puts on some type of hit and run or a run and hit.
On the ground to third. And it gets by him.
Having himself a really nice game at the plate. He kind of rolled over on this pitch a little bit, but he got enough behind it to shoot it through for a knock. And we'll take that anytime you can get him to find a hole.
Now it's the Dodger cleanup hitter, Freddie Freeman, for the fourth time tonight. And a swing and a miss. And that's that. Dodgers strand a couple. They lead this one, though, 5-1. Back here at Dodger Stadium, stepping in the long ball threat, Pete Alonso. The lefty ready, and a 1-1. And that one fouled off. Next offering is foul back. Here's a 1-2. And down on strikes he goes. And they get the leadoff hitter in the seventh. Went right after him there, Singy. No messing around.
Three pitches right there. Three really good fastballs in that at bat. But what stood out is all of them in a different part of the zone. He started them away. You look out over the plate as a hitter, and then he busts you in. You're not quick enough to be able to pull the trigger and turn on it. And then he finished up in the zone. Good velocity. Caught the top part of that strike zone. That's a great example of how you mix your locations. Just as important as mixing speeds.
Three and two now. Line drive. Hauls it in for the out.
Now batting. Third baseman.
So digging in, Eduardo Escobar. The big lefty turns, kicks, deals. Sliced hard but foul. The next offering misses, and that's ball three. And the pitch. Swing and a pop up. Foul territory for the catcher. Makes the grab, and that'll end the inning. Mets go down quickly. They're down here 5-1. Bottom of the seventh. And the batter now, Will Smith. Next offering is downstairs.
That's where you want it. It's a good miss.
And here it comes. Up the middle. Now the throw to first on the run. And they get the out on Smith.
Now back, the designated hitter, Max Muncy.
Max Muncy at the dish.
With this kind of lead, he can swing freely. Try to hit the ball out of the park. Do what he loves to do.
2-1 pitch is in there, and the count is even. The other way, and he beats the shift.
The left field, number three.
So up next, Chris Taylor. The pitch. That misses. Ball two. Good eye right there.
And that's awfully close. I don't know how you take that. He's seeing the ball out of the pitcher's hand really well right now.
And a pitch. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Grounded to third. Could be two. To second, that's one. Double play. What a twin killing to end the inning. Eighth inning coming up. It's the Dodgers 5 and the Mets 1. So the Dodgers have a new arm on the mound, Ruzdar Gratterol. He has a great slider with tons of movement. Ready to begin the eighth. So now here's the Mets DH, J.D. Davis. The wind of the pitch. Called strike right there.
Just a really nice slider down and in there. He wants to get the hitter thinking fastball, speed him up, and just subtract some velocity and add a little movement.
Righty to the plate. And downstairs. Stays alive. A wind in the pitch. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. And that's ball four.
Ball four.
Boom. Do you think you could draw a walk in the bigs if we gave you enough at bats?
Oh, that's a good question. I think that if they gave the pitcher a false scouting report on me, yes, I think I could draw a walk. The 1-1. And fouled off. Davis gets his lead at first with nobody out. And a 1-2 again. He swings and fouls one off. Next offering is fouled back. And a ball and two strikes. Little chopper rolls foul. Next pitch is popped up, and it's caught for the out.
The catcher, number 43, James McNeil.
James McCann up now for the Mets.
Now these guys definitely looking for a big swing of the bat right here. Try to close that gap. But, you know, at the very least, if you could find a way to manufacture that run from first, it feels like it's really important to getting back into this ballgame.
Oh, and that deflects off his glove. Play is made, two out.
Good onside run and sink on that pitch right there. Got inside on him and got him to bounce into that out.
Alex Vesia will take over here, and he'll do his best to hang on to this lead. Back to the top of the Mets order, and next for the Mets, Brandon Nimmo. And a pitch. In the air to left center, Bellinger on the move to his right. Pulls it in on the run. And that'll do it. Mets strand one. They're down 5-1. Taking over on the mound for the Mets, Seth Lugo. And he has some nasty breaking stuff. Back here at the ballpark, bottom of the eighth. Now it's the second baseman, Gavin Lux. Next offering is foul back. Left hand hitter waits. That one misses. So a leadoff walk.
Well, that's a nice job of grinding out that at bat. Saw a lot of pitches and ends up drawing the walk. Very gritty.
Man at first. And up to the plate comes Cody Bellinger. Right-hander kicks, deals. Curveball drops in for a strike. Here comes a pitch. And that one fouled off. Nobody out. Runner at first. Swing and a miss, and he got him. And he's down on strikes for the second time today.
Typically, that high fastball, if it's close to the top of the strike zone, a hitter, if he's prepared for it, can get to it. But that one just had that little jump at the end, which indicates there's a good spin rate on it, and it didn't decrease in velocity as that hitter's internal clock would expect it to, and that's why you see the swing and miss.
Ball two.
Next offering misses, and that's ball two. And a swing and a line drive at a right field and a base hit. They fired in quickly, so it's first and second with only one away.
No batter, number six.
Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good about what you did at the plate. You trusted your hands, you let the ball travel, and you took the barrel straight to it. That's great work right there.
Drew Smith on the pitch here. The offense will need to be ready for the breaking stuff. He's got a great curveball. So one out with two aboard. Trey Turner now. He's turned into one of the best shortstops in the game. Lined into right. That's a hit. And they stop him at third. So bases loaded with one away.
Now batting. Third base.
One out, bases loaded. So now Turner in on that right side. Righty delivers. And a foul ball, he stays alive. runs in to score.
Well, a great back and forth in that at bat. He had to lay off some really close pitches, and somehow Boogie found a way to keep the bat on his shoulder right there. I'll tell you right now, I couldn't have done it.
Bases loaded with one away. Freddie Freeman now at the plate. And the right-hander deals. Just missed.
Boog, in situations like these, the air can get really thin up there at the plate. Got to find a way to breathe and slow everything down.
Next pitch is outside.
First pitch strike from the pitcher, but then no panic at all by the hitter. Very patient, showing good discipline. Now he's in the driver's seat with the 3-1 count.
The 3-1. Fouled off to the right. Betts at third. Turner at second. Turner at first. One gone. Base hit, one run is in. Now two runs score, and they're pulling away up by seven now.
That's three singles in a row. To me, it's just a really controlled, balanced swing. He wasn't trying to do too much with it. Just stayed disciplined, got the barrel to the ball, and put it in play.
Will Smith steps to the plate for the Dodgers. He's already homered in this game. Two on, one out. Lifted in the air, right center field. And there's two away.
Now batting, the designated hitter.
A new arm into the game, the righty, Tylor McGill. He comes in with his team trailing by a bunch, so he'll try to keep it where it is.
Number 38, Tylor McGill.
Max Muncy will hit next.
Not the easiest thing when you're talking about a guy that's, you know, perhaps is going to be in the rotation, but maybe a long relief guy, to not start an inning, to come into an inning with pressure on it and try to get yourself comfortable.
And the righty deals. And a big swing and a miss. Gathers and throws to first. And that'll keep more runs from coming in. Inning over. Game six is on to the ninth inning now. It's the Dodgers 8 and the Mets 1. We go to the ninth. Now the number 2 hitter, Starling Marte. The pitch. Fouled off. He was late. Next offering way off the plate. The Dodgers bullpen with some action. Justin Brule looks to be getting ready for manager Dave Roberts. And a pitch. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Now one gone in the ninth.
Well, we saw a solid effort out of their starter, and the bullpen is following suit. It's just a good day as a manager or as a pitching coach when you can hand the ball off to multiple arms and get stability from all of their performances.
Here's Francisco Lindor. Next pitch downstairs. Now two balls and a strike. Out to center. Bellinger drifts towards it. He's got it. There's two away.
Now the first baseman.
Next is the cleanup hitter for the Mets, Pete Alonso. 1-1 is cut on and missed at a pitch upstairs. And the Dodgers are going to advance. They're through to the National League Championship Series.
You win a National League Division Series, you can breathe a little bit as the next one will stretch out to possibly 7 games. I'm sure they don't want to take it that far, but they're just going to be happy to get there. Congratulations, guys.
Here now is our final line score tonight. First for the victorious Dodgers, 8 runs on 15 hits. No errors. They left 11 men on base. For the Mets, 1 run on 2 hits. No errors. They left 3 men on base. Time of the ballgame, 3 hours and 10 minutes. Tonight's paid attendance, a sellout, 56,000. The Dodgers thank you for attending tonight's game. And as you leave Dodger Stadium, we remind you to please drive home safely.